relationships don't have to be so complicated and ambitious if we keep in view what in the end actually makes them fulfilling. If we boil matters down, there might really just be three essential things that we want from a lover. Firstly, kindness. A partner who is gentle with our imperfections and can good-humouredly tolerate us as we are. Secondly, shared vulnerability. Someone with whom we can be open about our anxieties, worries, and the problems that throw us off balance. Someone we don't have to put on a good front for. Someone around whom we can be weak, vulnerable, and honest, and who will be the same around us. Thirdly, understanding. Someone who is interested in and can make sense of certain obscure features of our minds, our obsessions, preoccupations, and ways of seeing the world, and whom we are excited to understand in turn. If we have these three critical ingredients to hand, we will feel loved and essentially satisfied whatever differences then crop up in 100 other areas. Perhaps our partner's friends or routines won't be a delight, but we will be content. Just as if we lack these emotional goods and yet agree on every detail of European literature, interior design and social existence, we are still likely to feel lonely and bereft. By limiting what we expect a relationship to be about, we can overcome the tyranny and bad temper that bedevils so many lovers. A good, simpler, yet very fulfilling relationship could end up in a minimal state. We might not socialize much together. We might hardly ever encounter each other's families. Our finances might overlap only at a few points. We could be living in different places and only meet up twice a week. Conceivably, we might not even ask too many questions about each other's sex life. But when we would be together, it would be profoundly gratifying because we would be in the presence of someone who knew how to be kind, vulnerable, and understanding. A bond between two people can be very deep and important precisely because it's not played out across all practical details of existence. By simplifying and clarifying what a relationship is for, we release ourselves from overly complicated conflicts and can focus on our urgent underlying needs to be sympathized with, seen, and understood.
Twelve early signs your relationship might not last. 1. Your relationship is solely about the romantic pull. Romantic attraction to your partner is important in any relationship, being part of what forms a solid bond, not the entirety of it. A healthy, strong relationship also consists of having something in common with your partner other than the romance. Without any similar interests, goals, shared experiences, or any other kind of common ground to stand on, the foundation is weak, with little to build on. Like the little pig with the straw house, it can collapse easily. 2. You don't like their friends. Ever heard that saying? Tell me who your friends are, and I'll tell you who you are. There's certainly some truth to that. While it's perfectly healthy and fine for you and your partner to have your own friends, a problem arises when there is an active dislike for each other's social circles. As friends act as a reflection of the person, this implies that on some level, you may not actually like the person you're with. This could be an early sign that the two of you are not well matched. 3. You spend too much time together. On the social flip side, is your partner the only person you see, to the exclusion of everyone else? Spending too much time together with your partner may eventually erode your own sense of self. Sure, saying someone is your whole world sounds romantic. However, if taken at face value, this actually implies dependence on them for your identity and happiness. This is not healthy, nor sustainable. 4. Your relationship feels one-sided. It's one thing when your partner tells you they love you and care for you, but another when they don't show it in their actions. Do you usually start the conversation or plan your dates together? Do you feel you're giving much more than you're getting back? While relationships are definitely not competitions, both you and your partner should be doing the work to hold the relationship together. 5. You feel controlled. Do you notice more and more that your opinions or decisions are constantly overridden? Or maybe a decision was made without your input and the expectation is for you to happily follow along without a word? This may mean that your partner doesn't respect you or care about your feelings. healthy relationships require mutual respect. So being in a relationship with this kind of imbalance does not bode well. This person can change this by learning to value your opinion and stop being so controlling. 6. You can't be yourself around them. Yes, we've all heard and probably know that first impressions are important. We dress more carefully, put some extra shine to our smiles, and filter our personalities like an Instagram pic. So what about the second impressions, or third, or 100th, or 200th? By that point, should the relationship be healthy and strong, we shouldn't need to put on the first impression suit or perform all that prep before hanging out with our partner. If you still feel like that's required in your serious relationship, this is a pretty key sign there's going to be trouble ahead. 7. You don't feel accepted. Your partner feeds a constant flow of criticism to you for your perceived flaws, saying it's for the better. The critique is to change every aspect of you, from the way you dress to the way you speak. It's like they want a different person than the one in front of them. You may initially justify going along with it to salvage the relationship, but the reality is you're sacrificing the wonderful, unique, and valuable you for a person who doesn't see your worth. You deserve to be treated like the gem you are and not mistaken for a lump of coal that needs dressing up. 8. You fight all the time. Occasional conflict handled correctly is a healthy and normal part of a relationship, as it helps couples understand each other's differences better. If the conflict is constant and volatile, however, especially early in the relationship, this is a clear sign of incompatibility. All the energy from the relationship is sapped from arguing, with no chance of growing closer, as most conversations turn into a screaming match. It's not healthy, and it's definitely not sustainable for a long-term relationship. 9. You don't trust each other. Healthy, lasting relationships require mutual trust. Trust allows closeness, honesty, and vulnerability to occur, which are all things that strengthen a bond. A lack of trust in a relationship isn't something that will fix itself if ignored. This can look like many things, including checking their phone on the sly or frequently calling their friends to check on them. Issues will repeatedly return to haunt you until one of these outcomes occur. You learn to trust each other, or the relationship ends since there's no room to grow. 10. They're regularly mean to other people. Were you shocked when your sweet, soft-spoken partner was unreasonably impatient and rude to the waiter? It's a definite cause for concern when your partner acts one way towards you and another towards someone else. Do they regularly act like Jekyll and Hyde, being kind to you, then turning around and yelling at the driver, the waiter, the person in front of them in line? If the answer is yes, then you should be wary. They might simply be putting on a facade to win you over. 11. They're passive-aggressive. When your partner is passive-aggressive towards you, it means that there's an issue with the two-way communication in your relationship. It's perfectly fine to be frustrated or upset with each other sometimes. Having open communication about it and approaching the problem constructively is a healthy response. Making backhanded comments, avoiding direct or clear communication, sarcasm, playing the victim, or holding grudges against one another isn't going to do any good for anyone. And it will be the death of your relationship if it continues. And 12, the timing isn't right. Sometimes, no matter how much you want to be with someone, the timing just won't allow it. You might be at different stages in your lives and are on different paths for the future. Maybe you're not ready yet, or you want to put your studies and career first. Perhaps you're still getting over an ex. Whatever the reason may be, if the timing of it all just isn't in your favor, it might mean the tragic end of your relationship. He's gone, Kuiper.